So let's see a new topic, electrical energy and power. Okay, so how much energy is consumed, that is electrical energy, and what is the power consumed. So let me draw a figure first, then we will understand this. So here is a conductor. This is a conductor, a wire or some other conductor. So it has two ends, end A and B. So the potential at this end is VA and potential at this end is VB. So there is a potential difference. This VA and VB are not equal. There is a potential difference V that is equal to VA minus VB. And this potential difference is positive. That means VA is higher, VB is lower, so we get a positive potential difference. So in this conductor, so this VA and VB are the potential at these ends. Current I is flowing in this conductor. So why current I is flowing? Because of the potential difference. And you know that current flow always from higher potential VA to VB. So this is the direction of the current. So this is the total case. Current is flowing from A to B. Potential at this end is VA. At this end it is VB. And the potential difference is VA minus VB. And this is greater than 0. That means VA is higher. Now let us take a very small time T. There is a very small time interval delta T. Now in this small time, some charge flows from A to B. Again, since time is very small, charge that flow from A to B, that is also very small, that is delta Q. Delta Q charge flows from A to B in time delta T. What is that equal to? I delta T. Because what is the formula for I? I is equal to delta Q upon delta T. So from this we get delta Q is equal to I delta T. So this is charge flown in very small time delta T. Now let us see what is happening else. So first let's say before that time there was some charge Q at point A. So what is the potential energy of this charge Q at A? So potential energy was simply Q into VA at this point. Now similarly, if the charge Q at B point, what is the potential energy? QVB. Now we know that what is the difference in potential energy after this transfer. So the difference in potential energy is simply how much charge was flown? Delta Q. Delta Q charge was flown from A to B. And what is the potential difference? Final potential difference VB, because we always calculate final minus initial for difference, VB minus VA. So this is the potential energy. So delta Q, that was the charge flown. Here charge was at potential VA, here charge was at potential VB. So how much charge was flown? Delta Q and difference of this potential. So final potential is VB minus initial potential VA. So if you see, if we take minus common, that means minus delta Q. So inside this bracket it is VA minus VB. So what is VA minus VB? Is V. VA minus VB when we take minus common. So what we get? Minus delta Q into V. So this is the potential energy, change in potential energy if some charge delta Q flows from side A to side B having potentials VA and VB. So this is the change in potential energy. Change in potential energy is minus delta Q V. Let us put the value of this delta Q. So delta Q is I delta T, minus was already there and V is from here. So this is the change in potential energy. Now see, this is less than 0, that means it is negative. It is negative. Now you know that for a conservative system, potential energy plus kinetic energy is always constant. So if this potential energy is negative, that means potential energy is decreasing, that means kinetic energy must increase. If potential energy, let us say, decreasing by 1 joule, then kinetic energy must increase by 1 joule. If it is decreasing by 2 joule, then it must increase by 2 joule to make this quantity constant. So let us see what happens. So change in potential energy is negative. So the what would be the change in kinetic energy? Same change but with a positive sign. So since potential energy is already negative, so another negative will make it plus. So change in kinetic energy is minus delta U potential. So what is the change in potential energy with negative sign? Same change in kinetic energy with a plus sign. So minus is already here, minus minus, it becomes plus, as we can say here. So how much is delta K? Delta K is minus and U is already minus, so minus minus U. So it becomes minus minus plus 1. So here it is the change. So change in kinetic energy is negative of the change in potential energy, because the sum of potential and kinetic energy must be constant. So now let us put the value. Delta K is IV delta T. So delta U was minus IV delta T. Now delta K is IV delta T. This is with positive sign. Again see, this is greater than 0, that means it is positive. What does positive indicate? Positive in kinetic energy means the velocity of the charge carriers that were electrons, that is increasing, only then kinetic energy will increase. Because you know kinetic energy is 1 by 2 m v square, half m v square, that is kinetic energy. So if kinetic energy is increasing, you cannot change the mass of the electron, half cannot be changed. What is changing? V is changing. If velocity is increasing, then kinetic energy will also increase. So this is the case when there are no collisions. This kinetic energy changes only when there are no collisions and charge carriers are moving freely. Moving freely means they are not colliding with any other thing. But when we calculate this thing, so what we found, this V drift velocity was simply a constant. So what was that drift velocity? E tau by m. So this was constant, it is not increasing. Why it was so? Because every time this electron collides with an ion, it starts moving again and it loses all its velocity and it has to start again. So between the collision, so this is first collision, this is second, this is third, this is fourth, this is fifth collision. So between these collisions, so we can take an average of the velocity, that is almost constant. Why this increase in kinetic energy is not increasing in velocity? Only because there are collisions. So now major point is that potential energy has decreased, kinetic energy has been increased. Potential is decreased, kinetic is increased, but it is not seen in the velocity increase of the charge carriers. Then where is this energy going? Where is this extra energy going? So this extra energy in actual conductor, because that is the ideal case where the velocity of the charge carriers will increase, but in actual conductor, the amount of energy is dissipated as heat in conductor during the time travel delta T. So what will happen? So conductor will heat up and this energy will lost. As you see, many electronic devices, when you touch them after few minutes or few hours, they will heat up. So why they are heating up? Because there is no increase in the drift velocity of electrons or different charge carriers because of the collisions. Instead of that, heat energy is converted into this kinetic energy is converting into heat energy and dissipates into external environment. The things are heating only because of this electron collisions.